I was born in Brownie and I grew up on medicine.
I loved it. We didn't have neighbors, it was quiet. I was the oldest of the family.
And was it Rolanda?
Rolanda, we called her Itsy. She was really tiny, she was three. She was a cute little girl also. She was always raising cane and joking and laughing. My brother Robbie had fish. He could catch fish with anything. He had a little a twig, and he put thread on it, and he had a pin. He just took the little pin and he curved it into a fish hook, and he caught fish. My dad, they were down at the river, and Dad asked him, "My boy, where are your fish at?" Here he had cut at him, sticking out of his pocket. A little tiny. Yeah.
And were you close to Galila?
Yes, they lived with us.
What was her?
She was like a little tomboy. She was comical also. She was always laughing and joking. Matter of fact, she was attending a prom and she had this real pretty dress on, and my mother and grandmother told her not to wear her ski coat. And of course she had to wear her ski jacket. And so she snuck out the door and they looked and she went walking by with her ski jacket on and her prom dress. So they were upset with her. But I was thinking that same jacket, that's the one that she had on that day when she died in the flood.
I think all the people we talked to about this, no one lost as many people as your family.
Yeah.
Did you know who the guys on the bank were?
You know, I never knew until now.
Have you ever talked about what happened on the day of the flood together?
No.
I only talked about this about four times. This probably be the fifth time to anybody. I just stuck her hair in my chest.
It's something I never really talk about. It's hard to talk about. That morning, I heard my little brother and Galila. They were talking and laughing, and I got up there in the other room, and I looked, and I said, "What's going on?" And I said, "Well, there's water all over out there. We're thinking we should go swim." I said, "What?" So when we woke up, my grandmother and my mother, when we warned them, because at the time my dad wasn't there, and my mom said, "We need to get out of here now." When we left, the water seemed like it was rising even higher. My grandmother, Rosie Grant, she lived not very far from us. And then right behind my grandma Grant's house, there was another little home. My aunt Wheatsey was living there at the time with her children, and they were getting ready. They said, "We're gonna go ride with Edgar." He just had that little pickup, and that's when we all got in the back. We were trying to make it to the highway, which wasn't very far from us, and it was a little creek, and it was starting to get deep. So they said, "Well, when you go through it, just step on it." So when he started going through it, it wasn't even pickup length long. He stalled out. And just like that, the water like was getting worse and deeper. My cousin Linda Williamson and Gail, Jimmy Buell, and Kenny and Richard Tootsie, he was able to get out. And so was Nellie and Edgar. So that just left myself and my brothers and sisters, my grandmother Violet, Galila, Cora and her daughter Wheatsey and her four children, and my grandmother Grant. And at the time I didn't know this, but Papoose Rattler and Art DeRouche were two of the people that were trying to save us that day.
Somebody called us that there was some people in the pickup. So we came here and the family were coming up in a truck. They made it about as far as those first trees over there and it stalled on them, flooded.
We got out to come off the hill and there's the water all through. We come down to where the water was. We grabbed this bulb wire and a spare tire, Papoose's spare tire. We ripped it off there and our hands were bloody with that bulb wire, and we threw it out in that current, and that tire would float down. Sometimes it'd go by that pickup.
It's hollering at mom to, you know, get on it, but they said we can't because we have, you know, kids. We can't just very well get on it. You know, who do we take and who do we leave?
The first one that grabbed that rope was, I think she was a Cabell.
When I threw the tire, she grabbed onto it, but they were thinking that it might have hit her because she let go and she went under. And I remember her coming back up and she had her arms up in the air and she was screaming, you know, for somebody to help her. And my grandmother, Violet, she said, throw it to me. And she had a broken arm at the time. They threw the tire and she jumped on it and she would try to dive under to see if she could grab Galila. I guess once she did go under and she was able to see her, but when she went to grab her, she was just like disappeared.
Nobody there. Nobody. Didn't even see her.
I remember Mom telling me to hang on to Robbie, in which I was. And then I remember he slipped and I reached down and I grabbed him. And I think he started going into shock or whatnot, and he was swept from my hands. And my mother had Rolanda, but you know, I don't know. She must have been swept from my mother's arms also. And then my Aunt Weetzie, her children were swept away one by one. And she had, only one she had left was her son, Terry. And she was cradling him in her arms, and a log jammed a pickup. It hit it as it was going by. And it forced her forward, and her baby flew out of her arms.
And everybody was screaming and hollering, and that bassinet was only about that big. I see it floating away. Next thing, there was nothing.
And that was, I think after that, I went into shock, because I don't remember anything else. I don't even remember them. I guess they had a boat that eventually were able to try to rescue us.
Kay Hoyt brought the boat. And that's the one that floated down, and he came back. And he had to go straight against the water because he said it's too strong. So we tied a bunch of ropes on him and held him next to that truck.
My grandmother, Grandma Grant, she told everyone, get the children out, everybody else out, leave me. It was upsetting because I was thinking, someone should have told her, no, I want you to come with me, you know, at the time before it got too bad. But instead, you know, just leaving her in there.
That old lady, old Grandma Rosie Grant, was in the middle of that pickup, that windshield, just waving. People, the water's come up. That was it. Took everybody out of there. Didn't even look back.
I remember waking up that morning in a hospital, and I looked and there was these gentlemen sitting there, and they had cowboy boots on, and to this day I don't know who they were. Maybe it was Papoose and Art and them. And they were sitting there just more or less being little guardians. And then when I woke up, I looked at them as startled, didn't know where I was at or what was going on. And one of them had candy. And I said, here, they said, here's a candy bar for you. And they gave me two. And I said, oh, can I keep this one for my brother? And they looked at each other. So I said, where's my mother? And they said, well, she's down the hall. So anyway, they brought me down there. And I remember when we were leaving, my dad showed up. He was sitting in a lobby with my mother. And it still didn't really dawn on me what really took place or what happened, you know, what really happened to my brother and sister. Because nobody really talked to me. It's like I was on my own. They were in their own, you know, grief and whatnot. And like they kind of forgot about me. So I was trying to ask them what happened to Robbie and Rolanda, but they didn't really answer. And I know Dad always kind of held it against himself because he wasn't there. It wasn't his fault, you know. He couldn't even have prevented a lot of it, I don't think, if I'm happy. When I had the funerals, they didn't let me go. They thought that, you know, it hurt me, but it still bothers me because I didn't, you know, get to say goodbye.
Do you feel like you fully processed what happened to you that day?
No, not really.
I think these are the ones that bothered me the most because helpless, I couldn't help them. and watch him drown.
Do you talk about it much?
Mm-mm.
How many times have you told the story?
Once before. I had to give a talk at the flood memorial.
Do you think they should be having the memorials, or?
I don't know if it satisfies some people, but it don't do me any good because I want to forget about it. I don't want to remember seeing things like that.
Gets to you. That old lady. It's hard. You get to see them downtown, their relatives, and you think, oh, pretty rough.
Did you feel guilty?
No, not really. It was just something happened. That's the way it happened. It, you couldn't change it. Done our best, you know. Papoose and me. The rest of us, we tried it. Didn't work.
Is this helpful to sit down and talk with Art, or is it too painful?
I'd say it's too painful.
You didn't talk with your mom about what happened that day. You talked to your dad?
No. This is really the only time I'm ever really be able to. It seems like you'd think it would get easier, but it doesn't. Maybe it's you call guilt. I don't know. You survived and they died. And then you wonder what kind of people they would be. I was looking at a picture of us. There was my mother, my dad, myself, Robbie, Robin, and Rolanda. I'm the only one left. My mother passed away a couple years ago. Poor lady. She would have been through a lot in her lifetime. I don't think anybody ever really understood that. And my mother, she would always kind of get upset with me because I was always okay. Or like my father was always sick, he'd have a heart attack, and people ask like, how was your father? Oh, he's fine. And he wasn't. And mom would say, Rhonda, he's not doing good. And I was thinking, I know she'd be upset with me, you know, I need to talk about this. And but I think people get upset with me because I laugh and, you know, it's just hidden.
Do you think people should know about this history or in these stories?
I think the younger generation need to know.
If you were to tell any of your grandkids what happened, what would you tell them?
Stay out of the water. No, I'd try to explain to them what happened, but if they ask me, I'll tell them, but if they don't, I don't tell them.
Yeah, I feel better not talk about it. It's off my chest.
You know, just the other day I was thinking I'd like to actually find out who the person's that helped save us, and never knew. I'm glad I found out.
Well, next time you see Papoose, will you say anything?
Thank him for being there. Like I said, at the time, when I look at Art, I did not know. And I'm very thankful for Art. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you too. Yeah.
PBS, your home for independent film.